أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I am a lecturer in one of Nigerian universities, and what even took me to the position of my educational career of having PhD has to do with the sentiments and the belief I have for women. I believe Islam is the best religion that takes care of every aspect of women that no other religion, culture, law, anything can ever give. Unfortunately, right from the time I was growing, I discovered that these privileges, rights, provisions given by Islam were not actualized by most Muslim women. So much so that you find it difficult to believe. If you see the condition, the deteriorating condition of some Muslim women, that's you want to doubt that is Islam actually have any provision or sympathy for women? Is it all male affair? So that now took me up to PhD level. At my undergraduate level, I wrote thesis on women's rights to divorce. At master's level, I wrote on women's rights, Alahadona, from the court of law, and to cap all, my PhD is on the practice of Islamic marital rights and obligation of women. Contrary to the feminists who always claim rights, but that of Islam is both rights and obligation. So my writings has to do a lot on women. And I've participated in a lot of research at local level, national level, even international level on women and law, particularly Muslim women. Not only that, I used to participate in public lecture to give about Islamic stand on women. And not only that, the ideal and the reality, and possibly what account for the differences between the ideal and the reality, and the need to guide against all the un-Islamic cultural principles that have adverse effects on women. Not only that, I network with women group because I write a lot. I'm either in the class or in my home. I used to leave my home as early as 7 a.m. and go back home at 7 a.m., prepare for the family to ensure. So I do sleep at 11 and wake very early again. That's my routine days. So much because of the fact that I know I'm going to learn here what I learned about Malaysia, Kelanta, and this group. That was why I have to share other things, that this is a group that I belong to, even though we are far away, but I know I'm going to learn, and actually I'm learning a lot from the participants and even the audience. Not only that, we have several Islamic organizations in my country, in my state. We have some feminist organizations. We have local-based organizations. I'm a friend to all of them, though I don't have time to be with them. But when my attention is actually needed, they used to invite me, and I used to go there. In addition to that, I used to provide counseling services to women, particularly married women who have some grievances in their marriage. I give them courage and the Islamic succor to their problem. So much that at times I will be having some phone calls for 2 hours that I cannot just stop because of the problem, and thinking that perhaps I will be able to provide some solution for her to sleep well. So that used to take my time also. Then I try to make myself an example So much that even in my universities, I'm always there for everybody. And any female having problem, just go to Dr. Sherifat. Anybody, even women that they have marital challenges, among the staff, they say, okay, we have a woman who championed that cause. That's the number. So my number, my phone number is open to everybody, and my office is open to everybody. So that's what I do to ensure that Muslim women worldwide are able to actualize the God-given rights and privileges. So I'm happy to be in a city that has the belief that Islam is the best for women. And they are not saying it by ordinary words, but they are working it. And that is Kelantan. Alhamdulillah to be here. And I pray all of us will be blessed. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.